मैम भाव इज नॉट ज्वाइनिंग बिकॉज ही इज फेसिंग नेटवर्क प्रॉब्लम।
यस दिव्या मैम,
यस दिव्या मैम, इफ यू आर हैविंग एनी क्वेरी, यू रेज्ड योर हैंड।
नो मैम, सॉरी, बाय मिस्टेक।
ओके ओके ओके, नो इश्यूज नो इश्यूज, सो वी कैन स्टार्ट राइट।
यस मैम,
यस मैम।
और कोई ज्वाइन करेगा? एनीवन इज ज्वाइनिंग और वी कैन स्टार्ट। ओके अमृता मैम, फाइन, सो वी कैन स्टार्ट। ओके, इट्स ऑलरेडी 7:13। सो यस, गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन, गुड इवनिंग ईच एंड एवरीवन। सो टुडे वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग, यस गुड इवनिंग, सो टुडे वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट यू नो परफॉर्मेंस मैनेजमेंट, you know, integrated part of total HR process. Okay, you can say like that. So have you heard of this word before? Do you have any idea about this? Hello, am I not audible or is it like I'm not able to hear you guys? What is it? Snehal ma'am, am I audible?
Yes, audible ma'am.
I don't know, I think I am having only issue. Just let me rejoin, okay? Because I'm not able to hear anything. Hello, am I audible now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, okay, fine.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. The PPT is visible to all of you or you could see
this? Yes, ma'am, it's visible, ma'am.
Okay. I'm not able to see the PPT. Ma'am, could you... Okay, okay. Ma'am is also having some network issue. Actually, here now, it's heavily raining, I think. Because of that, network glitches are happening. Okay, no worries. We'll start quickly. Okay, just a minute. Just wait for 2 to 3 minutes. Ma'am will rejoin. Then we can start. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Yes. Just in between, if my voice is not audible to you or if I'm not audible to you, okay, just quickly write in the chat box or you can stop me and you can tell me. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Yes, yes, because I won't be able to understand that, you know, aisa hota hai, I'm talking and like I have no idea that I have lost the connection. So you just tell me that, ma'am, you are not audible or like that. Okay.
Sure, ma'am.
Yeah, sure. Thank you. Snehal ma'am, you joined back? Snehal ma'am, am I audible?
We can hear you, ma'am.
Okay, I think Snehal ma'am is having network issue. Let me check once with her. Is my screen visible?
No, ma'am, not yet, ma'am. We can't see your screen. Yeah, now it's clear, ma'am.
Okay, okay. Screen is visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so let's just quickly revise whatever we have understood. Okay, so till now we have completed this, right? See, methods of training, on the job, off the job. What is on the job, like what is the advantage, what are the advantages, what are the disadvantages associated to on the job and off the job. We have discussed all these things, and yes, we have looked into some training methods like case study, role play, vestibule, simulation, in basket, business games. Any of this, if you are having any doubt, you can quickly ask. We can just quickly revise it or recall it. Anyone is having any doubt in this? No?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Fine, then we'll quickly go to talent management, whatever we have learned. Anything you guys are having doubt in here?
Ma'am.
Any doubt in talent management? No? Is my slide is changing?
No, ma'am, we can just see the talent management screen.
Yeah, I don't know what is this technical glitch today, no? I'm trying to change it, but it got stuck. But just a minute, huh? So sorry for this. We can't help it. It's technical glitches and all.
Can I share the screen?
Ma'am, can you share the screen in the group, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am. If you are there, you can share. I don't know. It's not changing. It got stuck.
Yes, ma'am. I'll share. Actually, it's heavily raining here, so
the same thing. Yes, heavily raining and the network is very poor here.
So
yeah, that is the reason. So ma'am, yes, you guys are quickly. Yeah, yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, it's not showing option of share the screen on my screen actually. I'll again rejoin and then I'll share the screen. Just wait for 2 minutes.
Okay, let me just. Okay. By the time I'll try, okay. If it is visible to them or my slides. Now it is visible.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, just quickly confirm is it is changing or not. It's changing?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, fine. We are good to go then. Okay, so talent management. What is talent management? The process, this diagram we have discussed. Then this, why does organization need talent management framework? We understood that. Then integrated talent management strategy, we all have done that, right? Now it's time to understand performance management. Now, performance management, what do you understand by this word? Like, what is related, associated with this word? Like, what is it?
Performance management is a process to ensure the set of activities happening in the company, ma'am.
Partially correct. Good try, ma'am. But like, think of a student perspective, you can think. Performance management, what is it? Like, managing performance, right? In simple word, in layman language, we can say that managing performance, right? Am I correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So basically, it's the process of, like, in an organization, right? We already have discussed in a like brief way, what is performance management? So it's a continuous process. Okay, the word is very important. Okay, it's a continuous process or a systematic process. We could see, we can see.
Ma'am, have you changed the screen, ma'am?
Yes, it's in the performance management, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you. Thank you for like reminding, because I'm not able to understand now if I lost my connection. So yeah, thank you. So yes, performance management, as I was saying, see, it's a systematic process. When you are in organization, after joining, you would be assigned to some work, right? Goal. The goal, which is your, you know, goal as well, individual employee's goal, that should be aligned with organizational goal. So first of all, your employer, like manager, would be assigned to that to you. Okay, it's not like assigning or ordering, giving order like that. No, it's like a mutual decision. Okay, mutual understanding. Okay, the employer would be understanding your requirements, your wants, your desires, and then he or she would be aligned organizational goal with you, and then the achieve, like the desired goal would be set. Okay, so for that, once it has, you know, set, so for that, what we will do, we will plan accordingly, right? We'll, if there is any skills are missing, then we'll do training and development, we'll upskill ourselves, correct? Are we on the same board, all of you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So basically, here we can see again it got stuck. What is happening, ma'am? So sorry, I don't know what is happening today. Again and again it got stuck. Now is it visible? No, right? The PPT is not visible now.
Ma'am, now it's visible.
Okay, so if I am like putting into this way, you are able to see now, because whenever I am adding, putting into slideshow, it's not changing, the slide is not happening. Okay, it got stuck, it's getting stuck. So if I am putting in this way, you are able to see, you are able to read.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, okay, so I'm just keeping it like this way. So here, any one of you can read this definition one, what is performance management, what is written here?
Of an individual with respect to performance on the job and individual's potential for development.
Yes, so it's a systematic evaluation of an individual with respect to performance on the job, individual's potential for development. What is it meaning? It's saying that basically it's understanding your goal, assigning you to a, you know, desired goal, or which is definitely, which has to be aligned with organizational goal, right? There would be a systematic evaluation. The process is, has to be a continuous process. It's not like once, like after 6 months we do some check-in meetings or like that. Okay, with respect to performance on the job, whatever job you have joined, okay, for that particular role, whatever role you have been given, it has to be aligned with that. Okay, and individual potentials for development. Definitely in performance management, it's very important that the employer or the manager should look into that individual, the employee's potential. Okay, where the person is, you know, lacking skills. If something is like that, then definitely reskilling or upskilling would be needed. So that is, that has to be understandable in this process, performance management. Okay, now definition two, what is it is also very important. It's quite lengthier, you can get a clear idea from this. See, it is a formal structured system of measuring evaluating job-related behaviors and outcomes to discover reasons of performance and how to perform effectively in future so that employee, organization, and society all would be benefited. Okay? When we are, you know, working for an organization, we should, like, ethics. We have heard of this word, ethics, right? Organizational ethics. We should understand code of conduct. So whatever we are doing, we are definitely, that is for our benefits, but just a minute. Huh? So that is for our benefits, right? And that is definitely would be, by the way, like, we are giving something towards our organization and we are adding value to our society, correct? Let's take an example of teacher or lecturer or professor, right? He or she is giving his or her knowledge, whatever she has learned throughout her, like, life, right? She is adding value to the organization, like the society. Overall, she is adding value. She is helping to grow each and every individual, upcoming nation, right? So it's, if we, am I clear? Am I audible?
Yes, 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 ma'am.
Okay, okay. So it's a formal structured system, right? So if we talk about any corporate environment, right? After joining that organization, that should be, you know, there should be a clear understanding of the setting goals, proper planning, setting SMART goals. Okay, we'll look into what is SMART goals and all. And then evaluating that quickly, you know, weekly basis, check-in meetings, feedback, regular feedback, okay, regular manner meeting, where the employer should not be behaving like a boss. No, it's not like you should giving the order and they are performing that task, or they are, you know, just nodding their head and, okay, sir, we'll do that. No, it's not like that. Okay, it's like a mutual conversation where you have to understand that employee, what is that person is wanting, what is that person is, you know, asking for, how they can give their best or they can add value to achieve his goal as well as organizational goal. So is this clear? What is performance management? Basically, it's managing the performance of an employee after joining that organization, right? After setting their organization, like, goals, okay, which should be aligned with organizational goal, with the individual or the employee's goal. Okay, there should be weekly meetings or check-ins, or we can say there should be regular meetings, regular check-ins, and regular way feedback would be necessary. Clear?
Till clear, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So here, anyone just read it out, what is written here? Anyone quickly read?
Performance management is the continuous process of improving performance by setting individual and team goals which are aligned to the strategic goals of the organization, planning performance to achieve the goals, reviewing and assessing progress, and developing the knowledge, skills, and abilities of people.
Yes, so it is the continuous process. Why it is necessary? Because it will help to improve that performance, right? Employees' performance by setting individual and team goals, as I already have mentioned, which are aligned to the strategic goals, or we can say organizational goal. Planning performance to achieve the goals, how we can do that, how we can achieve goals, we should plan for that. Reviewing, assessing, these are nothing but the check-in meetings, giving regular feedback, and developing the knowledge skills. Upskilling or reskilling is needed, or like, we should understand that, we should analyze that, and we should assign that person for the particular thing. Like, if it is reskilling, then we should give them a training, right? And abilities of people, what are that person is capable of, what are their skills, we should understand that. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Okay. So purpose of performance management system. So I just want to hear from you guys. Can anyone tell me the first point? What is this point is saying or justifying? What is it? Quickly read this for the first point.
Ma'am, to improve the company profit margin.
Yes. So what is your understanding from this?
Ma'am, according to me, I think that by measuring the performance of every employee, we get to know about their work. So it will help to improve the company profit margin. So with the performance mark sheet of the employees, we will be able to improve the profit of the company by their work. So that's what I think.
Okay, who answered that?
Ma'am Swarna.
Absolutely great, ma'am. Correct.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
Yes, absolutely correct. Okay, so by managing their performances, right? Comparing their old performance with new performance, we would be understanding that where the person is lacking, right? How that person can improve. So if we understand that person is needed something, we can provide that and we can upskill or reskill that person, and definitely eventually it will help to improve company's profit margin. If that person is productive enough, that person is highly productive employee, okay? So definitely it will help to reach our organizational goal in terms of monetary, in terms of each and everything aligned with organization, right? So automatically profit margin will be improved. Now the second point, what is it saying? To guide personnel along a suitable career path. See, the person, if the person is having a the person is not happy with the current role, okay, but by means he has to take that job. So what, as a manager, as an employer, we should look into, we should think that, okay, yes, fine, maybe we are not currently having that particular vacancy, whatever is your desired, okay, goal or desired role. So we can do one thing, we can assign some job to that person, definitely, and quickly, if some vacancy is open for that role, what is that, desired role for that person, we can definitely shift that person to that role, right? Correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Internal group posting, internal hiring, internal sources of recruitment. Aligning, getting it. You have to connect all,
yes, ma'am,
every aspects of HR with everything, right? It's not only about recruitment, selection, performance management, compensation. Everything is interlinked, connected to each other. So here it is. Suppose that person has assigned to their desired goal only. Okay, then how we can see that person can improve, that person can grow in their career. Okay, how that person could be growing, how can that person could get that success, whatever he or she wants. We should plan for that. We should set the goal in that manner. Okay, now the third one is to furnish staff with valuable progressive feedback. As I have told, quickly, like weekly meetings and quickly feedback. Okay, quick feedback is necessary. Regular feedback. It's not like aaj meeting hua and then you will give the feedback after 1 week. No, everything is gone then. Okay, if you're having the meeting now and then, as I am asking you, right? If you're having any queries, if you're having any issues, you can ask directly and now, right? I already ask you. Each and every day we ask you, right? Me and Snehal ma'am, right? Na? So it's kind of feedback, giving feedback. If you are having any issues, if you are not clear with our lectures, so what we will do, we will improve ourselves, right? We will look into the problem that where we are lacking, and then the next session it will be recovered, it will be rectified. So by that way, understanding performance management of an employee, performance of that employee, okay, we should be able to give them a feedback, be it negative, be it positive, but we should give them a proper feedback, and that has to be very regular basis. Till now, everything is clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Then to ensure staff attains their SMART goals, okay, we'll look into this in a broader way. What is SMART goals? Okay. So till then, you just remember the full form of SMART. Anyone is having any idea what is SMART or like what stands for SMART?
No, ma'am.
No idea.
No, ma'am.
No problem. Okay. So it is basically, see, specific, you can write it down. Okay.
Ma'am, is it specific or measurable? I didn't remember. Responsible and time bound.
Yes, not responsible. Okay. Okay. So okay. Partially correct. Yes. Who answered me? Because I'm not able to see who is answering because I'm sharing the
screen. Ma'am, Swarna.
Okay. Yes. Today, Swarna ma'am is on fire, right? Good. So specific, measurable, achievable, relatable, and time bound. Okay. So we will look into each and every component of SMART goals, how we should set SMART and all. Till then, just remember what is the full form. Specific, S for specific, M for measurable, A for attainable or achievable, R for relatable, and T for time bound. Okay. The screen is visible, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Now, the last point is to ensure employees' goals related to and advance organizational goals. So it is the first point I have told, right? The employee or individual's goal has to be aligned with organizational goal. There shouldn't be any gap. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So clear till now? Everything? Zyada to nahi ho raha hai? It's not, you know?
No, ma'am.
I think your heads are like that. Nothing like that, right?
Yeah. All good.
Okay. 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 Great. Great. So the last slide. Will for today's session, it will be the last slide. Okay. Otherwise, it will burden you. No, I don't want to do that. Okay. See, stages of the performance management cycle. First is, see, the main aspect is to understand organizational goals and values. It is written in the top. Can you see?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Yes. So, first foremost is to understand organizational goal and values to which we should follow, to which we should understand, to which we should be able to align our goals. Okay. Now it starts with planning. See, again, it's related to SMART objectives. So set SMART objectives, agree personal, development plan, update role profile. Now it's all together. In a nutshell, we can say that understanding the organizational goal, aligning that person's goal with organizational goal, setting SMART goals, specific, measurable, achievable, relatable, time bound. Okay. Setting SMART goals. Definitely, it shouldn't be like you are giving order or you are setting, the employee is sitting numb, nothing saying no. It's not like that. Okay. It's a mutual agreement where both the parties should be aligning with the same boat. They should have a same like common agreement or common understanding commitment. Okay. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. And they should be definitely a development plan included, how that person can develop them, like develop their in their career or grow in their career. Okay. Now the second step is, or the stage is, act, right? So accordingly whatever we have planned, we should act right accordingly. So achieve objectives, carry out role, implement personal and development plan. So it's basically how we are doing the task, doing the goal, okay? How we are able to do or we are not able to do. What is it? Why we are not able to achieve the organizational goal? So we should be looking into that. Clear? How we are acting, how we are following whatever we have set, how we are performing, right?
Right, ma'am.
Yes, now the third stage is tracking. Here comes the most valuable part, most important integrated part of performance management. Look into their performances, check their performances on a regular basis, giving them regular feedback, tracking process, how we are tracking them, how they are going, like they are going good, bad, what is it? They are not able to meet their set goals, or so why they are not able to meet their set goals, or why is there anything like they're facing any challenges like that. So we should be in a, like, aisa hota na, when we order some food from Swiggy or Zomato, we track, right? When that person will come, where is that person, right? We do it, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, so it's basically like that. We have set a goal, okay? Like we have ordered the food, and now we should be track that person. We should be tracking that person throughout the time until and unless we achieve that or we receive that food. Are you relating? Like, are you able to relate what I'm saying?
Yes, I can relate it, ma'am.
Yes. Yes, yes. So it's basically like that. And giving them regular feedback, okay? Giving, maybe that person is not able to reach that goal, so we should look that why he is not able to reach. So we should provide some coaching or training like that, so that the person can upskill or reskill him, and then definitely that person will able to perform better, right? And the last one is review achievements, identify learnings. Okay, whatever we have done from the first planning, then acting or performing, then tracking, and lastly, when we have achieved that goal or that person achieved that goal, we should review each and everything, right? And we should be able to understand the learnings, key learnings from that particular project or that goal. Maybe we have, like, I have assigned Suwarna ma'am that, okay, ma'am, from next class, you would be the trainer, okay? I would be trainee, theek hai? Iske liye, you prepare, I'll be there to guide you, okay? After the session, I'll definitely have a conversation with Bhavna ma'am, and before that, before Swarna ma'am, okay, and before that, what we will do, we'll plan together, okay? Me and Swarna ma'am will sit, will decide what will be the content we will be delivering to you, right? What, how Swarna ma'am can perform that, okay? Is there anything she needs help or not, okay? Then why she will be, you know, planning for the content, I'll be giving feedbacks, okay, no, if there is some changes required or not. So that would be giving regular feedback. Connecting with your employees, okay? Connecting with Swarna ma'am each and every day before the next class, okay? So after that, what we will do? After that session taken by Swarna ma'am, we'll look into that, we'll review how the process has been done, okay? If Swarna ma'am has learned something or not, right? Is the set goal has achieved or not, right? Clear?
Right, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
I think it should be clear with all of you, right? Is it clear? Any doubts in this process or performance management cycle? The first,
no, ma'am.
Okay, so first and foremost, okay, just quickly tell me, just a minute. Okay, Vartini, ma'am.
Today, yes, ma'am.
not speaking much, anything?
I have network issue, ma'am. I just joined now itself.
Okay, fine, fine. No problem, no problem.
Sorry, sorry, ma'am. Sorry for the issue.
No. It's all right. It's all right. Today I was also having, Snehal ma'am also having network issues and all. We started late. No problem. Yes. So, Akanksha ma'am?
Yes, ma'am.
It is clear?
Yeah.
Okay. So, the process, what, like, we have understood the process, right? So, first of all, what we should understand? The organization and role, right? After right. that, what is the next step? What is the next step?
Understanding the organizational goals, then understanding
then planning, right? Planning how we can achieve that goal. Theek hai? Like and setting this goal.
Yes, okay? Correct.
Yes, then performing that goals, whatever we have set before.
Planning, right, ma'am.
Yes, and then tracking how that person is working. As I have given example of Swarna ma'am and me, right?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
How Swarna ma'am is working. Any help required or not. Then after all, everything completes and all achieve the set goals, we should look for review. We should yes. review that process, right? Yes. Okay. Is there any learning or not or like that? So everything is clear now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Divya ma'am, Soeb ma'am, Soeb sir. Kritika ma'am, Vartini ma'am, Akanksha ma'am.
Ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Clear.
Yes, ma'am. All clear.
All clear. Okay. Then we can stop it here. Okay. We can stop our session here only because I think it's thora heavy tha, hai na? It's quite heavy to digest. So go and just read whatever we have learned. Just have a quick recap, or quickly you can just go through with the performance management so that it would be clear to you. Okay. Tomorrow we will be continue with performance management only. Okay. The other parts of it.
Yes, ma'am.
So it would be very helpful to you if you guys can come prepare whatever we have discussed today. The process, what is it, the cycle, and the purpose. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, okay, ma'am.
Actually, I was trying to check the YouTube channel of Career Dreams.